Yeah, hello everybody. So my name is Tato Saran, and some of you guys might actually know me because I was the head tutor when you started studying a year ago. And yeah, I've been living in Stuttgart for the last year on 4-year EBA because I did my exchange year over here. So I did my double degree in business psychology over here. And right now I'm doing my internship here in Stuttgart, Germany, actually. The thing is that when I got my job, I put it on LinkedIn. Luis came to me and said congratulations, and I've always enjoyed helping out our school, Metropolia, and everything like this. I was part of Trombi on my freshman year, and also I was the head tutor 1 year later that, and I always want to be kind of part of the community and help out everybody on every way possible. And so then I said to Luis that, okay, if you need somebody to talk about getting an internship abroad or talking about my internship in international recruitment, I said like, yeah, you can ask me to help out anytime. And she gave me like this idea that maybe you could make like a presentation for my course. And right now I'm actually doing this for you. So the thing is that I have this presentation made for you guys about getting an internship abroad. So yeah. As I told you before, I'm working at an international recruitment at the moment at a small company named People's Place. So first, let's just introduce the place where I'm working at. At an international recruitment company doing recruiting in the whole Europe, basically. It's actually a super cool thing to do. We're having clients in most of the European countries. Biggest clients are in Germany because we're a German company, but we also have clients, for example, in the Netherlands, in Ireland, and so on. And most of the jobs that we are having are customer service and sales jobs for companies that are quite big. For example, Mercedes-Benz customer service center is one of our biggest clients because they have so much need for recruitment that they cannot handle it all themselves. So they have asked us to help them out. And this is basically what our company is doing. And what I'm doing in the company is also something like this. And I will tell a little bit more about that later on. So the application process for my internship was not like the most common one, to be honest, because I was looking for an internship here in Germany, and as I don't speak fluent German, I can understand German and communicate in German, but I can't work in the language. It's really hard as an international to get like an internship position because the companies are usually looking for people who are more experienced and people like in the international jobs because they like to have like interns who are Germans because their working language still in the biggest companies and most of the international companies is somewhat in German, but they still have like English parts. But for the English parts, it's usually more experienced workers and hired like experienced workers. So I started to look for a placement here in Stuttgart during my exchange year because I was feeling like, yeah, I want to stay here in Germany. I was here during the COVID time, so I didn't actually get the proper experience how living in Germany would be normally. So I was thinking like, yeah, I would love to stay here for a bit longer at least. And then I started to look for an internship over here because I've been living in Stuttgart for the last year. Of course, I was looking mainly from Stuttgart area, but I was also looking from places like Cologne, Frankfurt, Munich, and so on. But I was focused on Stuttgart area, and then kind of like by accident, I found People's Place because I was going through jobs in LinkedIn, and there was this one sales position, and it was for one client of People's Place actually. But then I saw that, okay, there's this company named People's Place, which is doing the recruitment for this company. And I went to the People's Place website. I've been interested about recruiting for quite a while. I want to have a career in HR. I'm also interested of being a headhunter someday, maybe. But this was something what I've been like dreaming about for quite some time to work in recruitment. So yeah. Then when I found the company, I was reading about them. I was like, okay, this is really cool. A small company doing this kind of recruitment in the whole Europe in English, the working language is in English. And I was also going through the people who are working at People's Place because they have like this more about us point in their website. And I went there and I found out that, okay, the international recruitment team lead is Finnish and she doesn't speak German or she doesn't work in German. So it's like, okay, this is like the best chance that I can have because if somebody in this position in the company is from the country that I'm from, there will always be some kind of like some kind of connection, easier to connect to them. And then I was like, okay, they didn't have position open, but I just did them like open application. The open application, that one, I focused a lot on how I want to have a career in recruiting, how they seem like really cool, to be honest, like how the company was speaking to me because I want to work exactly in the field what they're working at. And then I was like, okay, I will just write about this, tell something about myself, like how I have like could be good at the job. For example, when I was a head tutor, I did some recruiting to recruit the tutors. I was training the tutors. So I was doing something similar. Of course, it's not the same, but I had at least some kind of idea how recruitment works. And also I was just being honest that, okay, I'm really, really passionate about the field. I would love to work for you guys. And when I had sent it straight away after this, I went to LinkedIn and then I sent a connection request to the Finnish recruitment team lead. That okay, I send you like this application. Did you receive it? It will be nice to hear from you what you were thinking about it. And actually next day she responded to me, hey, we got your this open application. It was really personal, it was super nice. Like, how would you feel about having actual like a interview with us in the next couple of days? So then I had done the application on Monday. I got like send a message on LinkedIn on Monday, and then on Tuesday I already got an interview for Wednesday. So yeah, then on Wednesday I had this first interview with the Finnish team lead, and yeah, it was super nice. She seemed interested about me. I was super interested about company, and they could like clearly see it, and there was really good vibes and really nice conversation between us. And then she was just like, okay, yeah, all seems really good. I will send your information to my boss and she will have another interview with you, the owner of the company, then Caroline. And then I had like the Caroline send me an email a couple of days later that, hey, I got all this nice information from Linda about you, but I'm going to be on vacation for the next 2 weeks. So after these 2 weeks, could we have the interview? I was like, of course, yeah, that's completely fine. That's perfect. And then after 2 weeks, I got the second interview with Caroline. The same thing happened all over again. Like, okay, there was really nice vibes, really nice conversation with her about the company. I had really dug as much that I could find from the internet that I actually knew about the company already. And she was like, yeah, you have done good research. She was asking me questions like, okay, how would you find information about the clients or find information about different job fields when you're recruiting for completely different fields? And I said, yeah, one thing would be that I will be asking my friends who are working on this field. And she said, yeah, that's perfect, because the network is one of the most important things you can have in recruitment, because then you can have some really nice inside view from somebody else who actually knows the field when you have been talking to them. So this is one of the things that actually impressed them, because I had been thinking through this beforehand. So next thing is that I'm gonna give you some tips what I noticed from my own application process. First of all, personalize the application. Use like, get some information about the company, the field, what they're doing. Personalize it the way that why you are interested in it, but then also keep in mind that in the application, they want to know what are your competencies for the job. So you also have to tell a lot about yourself. But then at the same time, you also have to show that you're actually interested about them. Then the follow-up, it's quite important. It's not like that you have to do it every single time, but it's giving a good image if you're sending an email, if you're calling to them, or if you're contacting them through LinkedIn, like after you have sent the application, just like make sure like, hey, did you receive my application? Could you give me some feedback about it? This is something that they also see, like, okay, this person is giving a little bit extra effort because of this job. So they are actually interested and it's showing your interest to them. Then do some research about the company for the application itself, but especially for the interview process later on. Then be personal. You have to give some kind of insights about yourself, because you're selling yourself as an applicant, as an employee for the company. So you have to actually show some personality, show something different that will actually make the like good impression, that they will have an image in their heads like, okay, this guy, He really wants to do this. He's really interested and he really wants this job. So just be personal, tell about yourself, tell about your qualities, and still try to make it something different from everybody else, because Luis is for sure talking to you about these so what's. If you're just saying that, okay, I'm a team player, I'm doing this and I'm good at this, and it's just like so what's. You have to show why you're a team player. You can say, okay, I've worked in teams during my studies. When I was in Trombi, I was part of or like the board. I was the secretary and also the treasurer of Trombi, but I was also helping out everybody else. So I was like saying, like, even though it wasn't my job, I was helping out people to arrange the events. I was helping out at this stuff, and this is how I'm a good team player. And then I'm social. I was saying, like, yeah, I have friends all around the world. I'd like to travel to see my friends, learn about new cultures, which is really an important part when you're working international environment, that you actually have international like experience and that you really enjoy being international. And then also you have to be consistent. This is something important because I applied, I don't know, to how many different like positions in all around Germany, and most of the time you will just get the thank you for your application, but we are, have decided not to go further in the application process with you because we have some better candidates. This happens because there are so many people who want these jobs, and you have to be just consistent and believe in yourself that at some point you will find that right match and you can always try again. There is always these thank you, but not thank you messages that will come up. But you have to be consistent, you have to keep on trying, and by this you can really achieve to get like proper internship, get a proper position. And this is what you have to do. Be consistent and believe in yourself and don't give up. It's just something that you have to do. Just don't give up. It's gonna be frustrating for sure. It was for me. It has been so like this for so many friends of mine, but just be consistent, believe in yourself, and you will achieve it. But now I will tell you a little bit about my actual internship. So yeah, what my internship is consisting of is that I'm officially international recruitment assistant. So I'm helping out the whole in the whole recruiting process from the start to the end. For example, I'm doing sourcing, I'm doing screenings about the applications, I'm checking people's CVs, and like the first part. Then I'm doing the contacting, sending emails to the applicants like, hey, you have applied for this position and we would like to have an interview with you to get to know a little bit better, like to each other. And also sending emails that, okay, sorry, but your application is not exactly what we're looking for. And also when you're doing sourcing and you're looking for a person from LinkedIn, you have to like send them a cold message like, hey, your CV or your like qualities match with this job, so would you be interested in applying for this? And then one thing that I'm also doing is database handling. We have our own database for applicants and for clients for jobs and so on. So I'm doing profiles for applicants according to their CVs. I'm updating like during the recruitment process. Okay, we had the interview, so now we have this information and we will write this down over here in the database. And we also put our job ads and everything like this over there. But this is something that I haven't done yet because I've been just working here for 2 weeks. But this is something that I will be doing, adding some job ads and also adding some clients maybe someday when we get like new client or something. And then I'm just helping the team in anything needed. For example, last week I was helping out one of my colleagues that I just went to her interviews. She was having a couple of interviews last Friday. I was there taking notes about the applicant while she was focusing on the actual like the interview part, talking and getting the right answers and asking the right questions. And at the same time, I was writing everything down that they were talking. Then at the same time, one thing that I was that my sorry my headphones just went off because I'm not using them, sorry about this. But yeah, then also what I was doing was that one of my colleagues, they had a couple of interviews and they need to make up like this kind of sheet that you sent to our client about the applicant, where you have the motivation to work for the company. There you have the qualifications. You write what kind of personality the person was, and you write this on a sheet of paper that is made by our own company, and it's always looking the same, but the like it's different for each candidate, like what kind of salary expectations they have, what languages they know, and so on. And then I'm also studying the clients. At least now at the beginning, I'm doing lots of research about our clients, what they're doing, different job fields, because some of them are working in IT, some of them are in automotive industry. We have also some pharma companies, so I have to know some details about each profession, about each client that we have, because when we're looking for somebody to work there, we have to actually know ourselves what the job is about, because the recruiter has to be really aware about the job, because the applicant will ask us questions. Okay, what are my tasks? What are the qualifications? What is the most important thing about my job? And you have to know it as a recruiter too, even though you're not recruiting for your own company, you're recruiting for a client. So it has to be like proper research about each client's different jobs and everything like this. So this is something that I've been doing a lot at the beginning of my internship now. Luis asked me to keep this quite short, and I think that this is basically, in a nutshell, everything. But I will leave here my contact details. So if you have any questions about getting an internship abroad, what am I doing, how is recruitment field, just feel free to contact me on any of these platforms. LinkedIn is the most professional one, and you can find me with Tatu Sairanen from there. Then my email, this is my working email, tsairanen@peoplesplace.de. Then my Instagram is Tatunen. This is like, you can always come to send me a message anywhere, or you can come to ask any questions anywhere you want to. That's completely fine by me. I would love to answer to your questions, because I didn't have too much help when I was doing this, and I feel like it's something that is really appreciated when somebody is there for you to tell you how to do something, how to write a nice cover letter, or how to get a job in Germany, or how is the working life in Germany, or how is the life in total in Germany. You can also contact me about exchange, because I've done 1 year exchange now, so I have plenty of information about how exchanges, how it is like living abroad, everything like this. So I would be like loving to help you out in any single way you want to. And also to Luis, just ask from Luis, like, hey, can you give me the contact information of the guy who was giving us this short video speech? It's not like too much what I told here. It's not too much in detail, but I hope that you at least got something out of it, and I hope that this will help you somehow in the future. But yeah, the main things are, when you're applying, just don't give up. Try to be like personal, do some research about the company when you're writing the like cover letter. Write about the company, but focus on yourself to bring out your qualities in something like more personal way. Why you're good at this, and why do you want to do this job, and why would you be a good candidate for this job? And this is the thing that will actually make the biggest impression to your future employer. But yeah, so I think that is all. If there's any questions, just feel free to contact me. I would love to help, and just enjoy staying at Metropolia, because I did really, it was great school. And yeah, just I will say to you, just go abroad, have at least an exchange, do an internship abroad, because this is one of my like greatest experiences in my life that I can do, just be living abroad, living a normal life and everything like this. I really enjoy it. And I hope that you will get the same kind of experience, and just be brave and just go for it. Yeah, thanks.